Congratulations po, we're back to The Voice.
Oh, thank you very much.
Ano po pakiramdam? Magko-coach po ulit tayo?
It feels good. I mean, it's another round of it. It's a time to mentor and I guess a new batch of artists, right? So always fun. Better than last season, I felt, right? Because I don't know, last season was more like just getting back on it, you know, after such a long break, and then this new coaches. So now it just feels a little more comfortable.
Bamboo, what's the most fulfilling part of being part of something like this?
It's easy. It's the kids. It's sort of giving back. It's that idea that it's you know, I've been playing for a while here. I've been in the business for so long, so be able to share and you know, just a mentor, be a small part, and you know, let's not exaggerate, even as a coach, a small part in these kids' journey to who they become or the artist they become. That's the best part.
Except, medyo matagal na pong coach ng The Voice. Nagbabago ba yung coaching styles mo?
I don't think so. I mean, it's always been the same. My motto is like, I've always been like, let's just keep it real, be myself, and just be honest. Right? And then it's more of being reactive to the children, right? To the kids or the artists, right? Whether it's kids, teens, or whatever.
Na-mention din ni Sir Martin kanina na medyo naging nag-jive na yung mga personalities ng
yeah,
coaches.
I mean, it takes time, right? As always. I mean, we all knew each other previously, even last year, right? But it's a matter of, like, again, going into something different. I carry that history of being in the show with all the other coaches from before, right, and that memory of them. So it's hard, right? But this year, sort of, it felt easy. Yeah, it felt pretty, like a breeze.
Napansin din niya, iba ka daw this time.
Sabi niya? I don't know.
It's
I don't
stricter.
I don't know. I just think I had more sleep.
Bamboo, besides syempre talent and then you're teaching them skill then technical skills, what do you think is also important for these young teens to know if they want to succeed? Because syempre it's not just talent, from your experience.
Yeah, so what's important? I think ano ba yan? like because I try to put them out of the setting of a competition, and I try to make them live, eat, sleep, and think like an artist. So at the end of the day, regardless of, because we all know we can't keep all the kids, right, or the artists on our team, so they have to go home and bring something. And that's the hardest part on my part, right? Parang, how do I do this in such a, knowing it's such a short time? Na parang, it's always parang pakiramdam ko parating bitin eh, right? Like, I wish I had more time. Given we know na the parameters, eh, no katagalan talaga to eh. So as much as possible, you can sort of impart that. You try to build an experience for them, na sila, like they you know, like if you're going to school together, they feel as a team. Like years later, let's go back. We were batch whatever, right?
Yeah.
I want them to remember that. It's those memories. And then if I do that, then I succeed na, right? I succeed in that sense.
What are you looking for sa mga auditioning for this
season? I was very specific. I was looking specifically for parang from my best look, kasi you turn around, you don't know what's gonna happen, but artists, so I try to get parang a pulse na parang, okay, this is gonna be an artist. I want, parang vision ko is like kids just playing piano, playing, you know, during the battles or just playing guitar, multi-instrumental, you know, so I'm looking for that parang energy. That's always been sort of what I wanted for Camp Kawayan, so sana. I mean, we're done with the first phase, so we'll see the second phase. I get to know the kids and how well they play, and we'll see what happens.
Is there any secret formula ang Camp Kawayan that could, like, makukuha ang pagiging champion for this season?
Secret formula? I don't think so. I think it's every season's different, so you just have to, you know, just, I guess, how do I say this? Play, I don't want to say play. Play is parang pangat to say it. But you just sort of have to react to the kids. Whoever you have in front of you, you just give the proper focus on them. There's no formula. Because every season, everything, it's always different. Right?
Coach, last season on The Voice Kids, you were the coach behind the champion last season. So may pressure ba for this season of The Voice Kids na mahanap mo yung champion?
You know, I've never had pressure. I mean, if I think about it, I've had like disappointment, like, but oh, I hope the people saw this artist shine and they deserve to get their flowers, no? They deserve to win this, parang ganon. So, but then I know that's not in my control. Wala ako dun eh. So it's a matter of everyone else sort of giving their voice. That's part of the whole thing. So, but alam ko lang, as long as I put the work in, my artists put the work in, and then we do our best on that given night, okay na ako. Like, even when, like, previous seasons, yung, maski hindi nalo yung isang artist ko, whatever, but I felt in my heart na parang that they won this. Till today, I call them champ. Like, I go, champ. And they know. Because they know naman eh. You have to respect that. And I go, like, dude, we own this one, right? We performed toward the best of what we could do, and then we own that moment. That's all you can ask for. Okay.
Coach, segue ng question.
Yeah.
Concert.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm excited. I'm excited for that. I mean, we've been, to the run-up to this whole, to the voice as well, voice teens, I've been rehearsing almost feels daily, right? Because it's a great time. It's getting to see the guys again.
Yeah.
And looking forward to just playing na lang on the 17th.
Hindi ba masyadong, hindi ba nagbabanggaan yung schedules ng The Voice and the preparation for concert?
Well, how honest can I be? Well, of course nagbabanggaan, diba? Of course it does. There is conflict, but then, again, you sort of have to make time for that, right? Because I do understand, like, that's a big thing. That's like a milestone, right? That reunion show. But this is, I'm also part of this family, right? The Voice family, right? So when they give me that call, I'm here, right? So ganun lang naman yun. It's conflicted, but I'm here, right? It's not easy. That's why I said, I wish I had a little more sleep.
Last question.
Bamboo, syempre, diba, everyone's really excited for your reunion concert. You're so far with the rehearsals, the practice. What has been the best part, or most enjoyable part for you heading to this?
What's the most enjoyable part? It's just playing the music again, right? Hearing us sing together. You know what I mean? Just those memories sort of rush back. But we're trying to focus in the present. We always say, okay, let's not look too far back, right? Mm-hmm. Let's just keep focusing on what's going to happen right now. And that's been pretty cool. I've been happy. Mm-hmm. Happily and surprised.
Nasaan na po? Lahat po ba ng kanta, maririnig po ulit sa concert?
Ano, what do you mean by that?
I mean, lahat yung mga...
Classics.
Meron po ba iniwasan na kanta or wala? Lahat po ba ng classic songs ng Rivermaya?
I don't know if I can say. I don't know if I can blow that.
No, definitely.
You can watch the concert.
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
We'll see you there.
Yeah. No, but it'll be, yeah.
It will be enjoyable for present fans and old fans.
I agree. I think so.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.